Paul Byron fired up, ready to go. Hasn't played since February the 3rd, but the forearm has been medically cleared. He is good to go. And how about Max Domi? Leads Montreal with 51 points. He's got a career high in goals. Could get a career high in points as soon as tonight against Columbus.
Here comes Domi over the line, waits, fans on it, and grabbed there by Foligno, and Drouin trying to strip him, he can't. Shaw can't grab it. Werenski steps up into the zone. Right side, Jenner backs it up, Savard shoots, stopped by Price. And coming back the other way quickly, Domi's got Drouin going to the net. Domi waits, his pass, back to the skate, and he scores on the rebound.
After giving up a 4-on-2, David Savard wide open in front, and Carey Price kicks it aside, and it's Domi and Drouin off to the races. Max tries to sauce it across, catches Robinson's foot, right back to Domi.
I guess when you have a 2-on-1, you're those
offensive
two guys.
Players always have a little juice.
Here comes Eric Robinson, sets it up for Bjorkstrand, and he just missed as it trickles wide on the rebound.
Because he wanted the big contract. Then he kind of struggled when he got the big contract, living up to it. But now he's settled in, and he is a dynamite player.
Now Kotkaniemi gets the shot away. Rebound! Byron scores! Byron, 2-0, Montreal!
Shooting breaks down defense. Even if you miss the net, and Paul Byron, heading towards the net, takes advantage of the carom.
This line was really good to start the year. Riley shoots it, maybe waited a half second too long, and Jenner sends it ahead. Anderson trying to get things squared away. Walks and scores! Josh Anderson with his 21st of the year, a minute and 5 seconds into the second, and Columbus is on the board.
I wonder if Anderson was going top glove, because that's where Carey Price thought he was, and he just went mid-net.
Domi coming in. That takes a good bounce for Anderson. He'll drive to the net. Anderson breaks save and breaks. And it just sits there.
The most influential Columbus forward takes advantage of the weird curling stone as the rock slides in the middle.
Drouin, they quickly come out of the zone. Kulak is up there again. Nudibara tying him up. Swooping in is Andrew Shaw. He is bodied effectively by Jones. He can cover a lot of space, can Jones. Anderson has it. Anderson shoots. Stop. Rebound. Foligno scores. And Foligno goes to the net. Anderson shoots it, and Foligno is rewarded with the game's tying goal. It's 2-2. Domi will bring it back in. Here's Domi from Drouin. He makes a great move. And Shaw. That puck is on the line. Where is it? Underneath Bobrovsky. The Canadians come within inches of taking the lead.
And I wonder how close is the goal line this gets. That's a brilliant move. And there you see it bounce up into Seth Jones. Seth Jones' hand, right hand, jumps out. And I wonder if he grabs this right there on his hip.
Tatar back to Jordy Benn. He'll wait, slides it through. Kotkaniemi back for Benn, and he'll take it toward the corner. Benn waiting. Gallagher's there, tipped in. Set up Tatar for his 19th of the year. Empty net now for Columbus. Armia can't drag it out. Wenberg is on it. Foligno goes to the goal. Wenberg for Savard. Quick shot. Stopped by Price. Loose in front. Anderson is there. Knocked away. There's a shot and a save made by Price. 9.4 on the clock. Canadians get the puck off the faceoff. Rattled around by Weber. Kept in. Seth Jones. He'll move it down, but Atkinson missed it, and the Canadians do hang on. They win it.
Montreal did what they had to do. It wasn't the prettiest, it wasn't the best, but Carey Price was solid. They found a way to score goals. They got the game winner even after giving up the lead initially. And Montreal wins at home, snapping that losing streak, something they have done very well all year long.